Greetings people from Beer's Blend, my name is Ronald and welcome back to another whiskey review. It's Friday again and that means another review of a single malt. In this case it's a single malt. It can also be a blend, maybe a bourbon in the near future. But today we have one of my favorite whiskeys. Just because it's damn good. Are you sitting comfortably in your nice chair or couch or, well, whatever you're sitting in, I hope you're comfortable. But ladies and gentlemen, let's get into the review. Today we are reviewing Lagavulin 16-year-old Islay whiskey. It's a peated one and I will talk a little bit more about peated whiskeys in a detailed video. That's kind of the way I want to go with my whole reviews. In my reviews, I will just talk about the whiskey, a little bit about the brand, maybe a little bit about what a whiskey stands for, or yeah, what kind of name it has and where it comes from. And I will also like make a detailed video talking more about the distilleries, talking more about some known terms in the whiskey industry, like what is this whole peated whiskey thing. Well, to give you a little introduction, peated whiskies, the way you get a peated whiskey, like in the case of this Lagavulin here, is the barley needs to dry before the whole fermentation process, etc., etc. And the way Lagavulin and Laphroaig and Ardbeg and, well, other distilleries who produce peated whiskies do this is to heat the barley with peat fire. And, well, then you get this, like, smoky feeling into the whiskey. And in my opinion, it's really nice. And in the case of this Lagavulin right here, let me show you the bottle. It's a nice green, brown bottle. It's nice. I just like it. Nice presentation here. And, yeah, the whole thing with peated whiskies is this is a kind of old peated whiskey, 16-year-old. The older the age statement or the higher the age statement, the less intense peatiness the whiskey has. So this one was quite peaty in the beginning. It has been oxidizing in the bottle for how long? I think over half a year now, I believe. Yeah, that may be the case. And it's at the point where the peat is minimal, still noticeable, but you can just experience the different flavors and aromas this whiskey has to offer, and I really like that. By the way, I'm in a new setting at the moment. Let me know what you think. I like it. I am recording this in the evening now, so it's a little bit better to consume evening whiskies. What's whiskey in the evening? That's what I was trying to say. But Lagavulin 16-year-old. It was quite peaty in the beginning. I don't exactly have any other really references to peat in whiskies. I don't have Ardbeg 10. My Oegdal is still closed. I don't have Laphroaig 10. I will be getting some more, like, really intense young peated whiskies. But this whiskey is one of my favorites. And if Lagavulin can produce a whiskey that tastes like this one does, it's so good. This one does need a little bit of time, so let's pour a nice tasty little dram and let's talk a little bit more about the whiskey itself. Oh, nice, nice sound. A nice, tasty little dram. Alright, let's take a look at the bottle. Now this one is oxidizing a little bit. Okay, Lagavulin Distillery, Port Ellen, Isle of Islay. The Isle of Islay is located at the west coast of Scotland. The exact location, I don't know, I'm not a Scot, but I believe it's on the west coast of Islay. It was established around 1860, so it's quite an old distillery, beginning of the 19th century, so yeah. Aged 16 years, log water rushing over Rocky Falls, barley malted over Moorland peat, slow distillation and long maturation in oak casks. This font is just terrible to read. I don't even know if you can read it, but my god. All help us to shape Lagavulin's robust and smoky character. Time, say the Islanders, takes out the fire but leaves in the warmth. That is true. This whiskey, you can sense it is mature, it's old. And I will, again, talk about this a little more, but it's not really the exact number of years that has been stated on the bottle or the box, but it's like, it's the active years. The uses of the casks. Are they using first fill? Are they using second or even third fill? Like, the casks are what is really important when it comes to whiskey. It's one of the most important things, in my opinion. The Strange Horse of Sunbale by William Black. Yeah, I am not really going to read that. I may read this at the end of the whole taste nosing thing. It's just a nice bottle design. It's really characterful. If you see this standing on a shelf... Okay. If you see this standing on a shelf at your local bar, you will definitely know it's a Lagavulin. You know it's going to be good. Lagavulin doesn't really have any bad whiskeys, in my opinion. They have the 8-year-old, and that's a really nice, interesting story, by the way. I saw that... I can smell it. But the 8-year-old 200th anniversary edition will be put in the whole standard range of Lagavulin. The 8-year-old goes around 60, 55 euros, dollars, pounds. This one is a little cheaper, around 50, 45, depending on where you get it. And I hope... The 8-year-old anniversary edition has a higher ABV, though. This one has 43. The 8-year-old has 46, I believe, or maybe even higher. But yeah, the new 8-year-old will be put in the standard range of Lagavulin, and I am really looking forward to tasting that. I have actually thought about buying the anniversary 8-year-old, but I don't exactly know if I am going to do it because it's a little high. Especially since this one is cheaper, the one that is twice as old, and normally the older whiskeys are more expensive. Not the case. Well, it is not the case because, well, the 200th anniversary edition has been marked up a little bit in the price because it's an anniversary edition. But that's all nice and dandy here. Does it have added color? Meat vibe stuff? Yes. Not a natural color, though. Kind of strange, in my opinion, because it's a dark shade of bottle, so why would they color the whiskey? But in my opinion, if they have added any color, then it isn't quite a lot, really. It's nice copper caramel color. Yeah, I don't know if it is being chill filtered. Maybe it says on the box. Nope. Huh. I have a little story on the back of the box here. Let's just read it. Let's give this whiskey a little more time in the glass before we consume it. Lagavulin. Many believe that this is one of the oldest distillery sites in Scotland. In 1816, local farmer and distiller John Johnston, okay, founded the first legal distillery here at Lagavulin, pronounced Lagavulin. Lagavulin, okay. After the Gaelic Lagan Muhal, the hollow where the mill is. Okay. Today, the four onion-shaped stills at Lagavulin are neatly tucked into a whitewashed jumble of buildings by the sea on Islas, pronounced Aila. 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 Okay. Rocky southern shore. So, south coast of Isla. Yeah, okay. Guarded by the imposing ruin of Duvangir Castle. Okay. There's nothing hurried about life on Isla or the dark, intense Lagavulin, which recesses the slowest distillation of any Isla malt. Then spent 16 years in old oak casks before being bottled. Does that mean we have third fill casks in here? I don't know. Pungent and potent. Reading is difficult. This is the Great Isla Malt. They actually state this as the Great Isla Malt. With richly peaty, deep, smoky flavors. It has an intense, long, ambrosial finish. Lagavulin is the majestic Isla destination origin around Scotland's malt. Six malt whiskies making regions, the other classic malts of Scotland. Glenkinchie, Dalwhinnie, Craigenmore, and Talisker and Oban. Yeah, it's part of the whole classic malt of Scotland range. I am thinking of buying some of those, but I know Craigenmore's basic whiskies aren't really interesting. Glenkinchie isn't really that interesting to begin with because it's the lowlands. Dalwhinnie, okay, Oban, and Talisker, sure. Alright, let's nose this whiskey and I will tell you all about it, give it a mark, and then we will talk a little bit more about the verse or story that is on the bottle of Lagavulin 16-year-old. I really like this glass. I can already smell it over here. Oh, nice. Actually, there is smoke. There is that really smoky note that was in the beginning of this bottle, just hanging around the glass. Nice. When you get more deeper into the glass, that smokiness, that really intense smokiness, is gone. It's like a fire. You have the core in the glass and just the smoke hanging around. It's so nice. If you like whiskey and you want to discover a little bit more, you should definitely give this a go. Yeah, there is some sea hints in there. Let me just clear the pipes a little bit. All right. Let's sit back and enjoy this sweet dram, shall we? Yes. I have a little bit of a cold. It's the season. I'm sorry. Yeah, definitely hints of the sea, like a hint of saltiness. There is no sherry maturation being used in the 16-year-old, I believe. I don't really know. I have a distiller's edition, which is sherry finished or matured. I don't know. But I am definitely getting some dark fruits. It's mature. I am getting the bonfire notes. This one is nice, rounded, but again, there's only that much left. Actually, yeah, about the label height. It's not a lot in this bottle at the moment, but I like this so much, and I tried it yesterday, so I was like, I have to record this while I still have some notes in my head. I definitely like this a lot. It's so pleasant. I can't really tell what's going on because my nose is stuffy, but and my watch is turning around. I have been hitting the gym lately, getting into shape a little bit more. Let's just go and taste this. At this moment in time, I am getting a lot of roasted ham. Definitely roasted ham in the taste, and on the nose I was smelling something. And that was that kind of smoked ham note, you know? Or some other meats, or some pork, maybe. Yeah, definitely something roasted, though. And I find it kind of strange, because yesterday I was getting, that was, while it had been sitting in a glass for quite a while, I was getting a lot of chocolate notes, not bitterness, just nice, full, round milk chocolate. And in the taste, some chocolate pudding. Not the bitter or really sweet chocolate pudding, just the nice, the way chocolate pudding was meant to be, you know? And I'm definitely getting some chocolate now. In the beginning, it's kind of gentle, kind of warming, asking like, how are you? Are you doing good? Yes, okay, well. And then it starts getting intense and full. It has a nice mouth feel. There is definitely that hint of smoke, but the smoke isn't dominant, especially in this stage of the whiskey. I remember in the beginning when I opened the bottle, it was really smoky. It had a punch to it, but I can now really sense the oldness, the matureness of this whiskey. It is solid, active cask use. It's just nice. Lagavulin did a really, really good job with this one. Definitely a 10, in my opinion. And the way I rate my whiskeys, I don't rate them on like what I am looking for in a whiskey and like gives it me the ultimate experience. I am rating a whiskey in the sense of, is it just good? Is there something lacking? Could the distillery have done more? Maybe in the chill filtration or the ABV department? I don't know if it is chill filtered or not. You have to look that up. I may put it in the description if I don't forget. If so, remind me and I will do it. But if it has been chill filtered, then I don't really notice it. It just has a nice, rich, full mouthfeel. I can still taste some hints of smoke on the sides of my mouth, and it is just a really pleasant whiskey. And this really shows how a bottle can change over time if you just leave it sitting in the bottle. Coming back to it, yesterday I was experiencing a lot of chocolate notes. I may be getting to that later. That's why I'm leaving a little bit in the glass. I'm hoping to get that whole experience, but I wasn't getting any of the meaty, cooked, smoked pork notes that I'm getting at this moment. I'm kind of looking for that whole chocolate, but there's definitely a campfire, a bonfire. I am not really getting that whole medicinal, iodine, hospital disinfection note at the moment. Some people are saying they are experiencing it. That may be true in the beginning of the bottle. I will try to review my Lagavulin 16 Distillers Edition in the beginning and in the end. So maybe do a re-review or an updated review on that. Because peated whiskies change a lot. It's one of the most expensive whiskey types there is. I will talk about that in detailed videos. But basically the whole peat maturing, peat maturing, Ronald, you're drunk. The whole peat stoking and gathering process costs money because it has to be done by hand instead of machine. Why? I don't know, but yeah. Now I am getting some chocolate notes. Chocolates. I'm getting some chocolates. Nice little chocolates. Forrest Gump. Yes, there's definitely chocolate in here. And yeah, I can kind of see it now because, well, we have been in this video, what, 19, 20 minutes? So yeah, a minute in the glass for a year in the cheers. A year in the glass for a year in the cask. Yeah, that's where I was going. Mm-hmm. Huh.
In the end, it's intense. And it turns into such a rounded aftertaste and finish. Amazing, amazing malt. The interesting thing is, in the beginning you get some smoke, it's nice, it's pleasant, then it gets intense. And all the flavors and spices and little hint of the sea with some, I don't know, kind of that sea smell, salty hint. There is no salt in this whiskey. If you want to try it, I've never done it. Just put a little, just one tiny piece of salt in your whiskey glass. You will actually die because it's disgusting. But I've never tried it. Some friends did it. I'm not gonna waste any whiskey on it. But there is no salt in this whiskey or in any whiskey for that matter. So yeah. But it's just a hint, a reminder. And that's how the whole tasting and smelling and nosing thing happens, you know? Just with your senses. And it's amazing what kind of memories smell can bring back, you know? Yeah, I'm definitely getting some chocolate now. I am trying to search for some cask characteristics, like some bourbon notes or some sherry notes. But I honestly don't know what type of casks they were using in here. If you know, then let me know. But I think it has been some... Yeah, I just don't know. I mean... Yeah, there is maybe some bourbon in here. I can see that. Some honey and sweetness may come from that. Not really a lot of vanilla, though. The honey may be there, but then it's like that really bio-type honey. Just that pure honey, you know, not that really sweet honey. More of the bitter honey, sour honey, if you know what I mean. Just like the pure honey that actually comes from a hive. I've never actually had it, but I've had some what you said, local produced honey, and yeah, it tastes completely different from the crap they factory produce these days, or put a lot of chemicals into just preserve it. And that's kind of the honey note I'm getting. So yeah, sherry, some fruits are there, yes. But yeah, most of all, it's just the peat, the distillery character, sea notes. It's just one of a kind. I'm not really missing any of the sherry notes, to be honest. I'm having a jolly good old time with just the things Lagavulin puts on my table, or in my glass in this case. Mmm. Mmm. Most of the intensiveness goes to the tip of your tongue. And now I'm definitely indeed getting some chocolate, bonfire, campfire, smoke. There's definitely smokiness in this whiskey. PPM, I don't know. In this whiskey at the moment, it's low. In this state of the whiskey. There's been oxidizing, not in the glass, in the bottle. I would say 10 ppm, maybe 15, while the normal Lagavulin more has like 30, 40, I believe. That's what I can remember that people were saying. But yeah, there is smokiness, but it's definitely not overwhelming. The smokiness is more there to round off the experience and just give that extra boost to the intensiveness of the whiskey. I can sense the smokiness around the glass, though. I think that's more like 25 ppm. It's weaker now because, well, it has been sitting here oxidizing. Yeah, definitely some vanilla. There is definitely been some bourbon cask maturation taking place here. Sherry maturation, I don't know. There, maybe actually. Yeah. It's definitely a combination of those two casks. Yeah. Whether it's been two-thirds sherry or one-fourth bourbon, I cannot honestly tell. But both types of casks definitely has been used in this whiskey. I can sense some darker fruits in the aftertaste. I think, smokiness, nice, smoky intensiveness. At this point, at this stage of this whiskey, I can say it's my favorite I have tried my whole whiskey career. Ever since I got into whiskey until the point of now, this has been my favorite whiskey. At this point, because in the beginning when I first opened the bottle, I wasn't really too convinced. I liked it because it was different, but it was really demanding. You had to be in the mood for it, but this is just nice. People that don't like really smoky whiskeys will love this. This is nice, and I love the ham notes in here. I've never actually noticed them before. And yesterday I was getting like the ham now was the chocolate thing yesterday. I don't know whether it's been a time in the glass thing, but I think we're around the same amount of time. The aftertaste is still going. It's nice, full, round. The finish is amazing. The whole entry or beginning of the whiskey is nice. It's gentle, it's friendly. It just says, hello, how are you? I am like a Volin 16, what's your name? And then it gets like into the really awkward questions, intense, and yes. It shows the character of the whiskey, and then it's just a nice goodbye and well, take care. It just says something that maybe like gets you excited or something, and then it just leaves and you're feeling good about yourself and saying, yes, that was a nice conversation, you know? And that's what this whiskey really does to me. It just says to me, like, it's a kind of caring, actually, like something someone comes towards you and just gives you a pat on the shoulder. Good job, buddy, yes. And that's what this whiskey does to me. It just makes me bloody happy. This is a really nice state, this whiskey. Has been at the moment, and I was feeling like I need to review this in the next couple of days, otherwise this will be gone. So yeah, I'll definitely enjoy this whiskey some more. Probably not for the next few days because I've had two drams in the last couple days. So and I want to savor this because it's so nice. Definitely a 10. Yes, let's read the nice little story that has been put on here. The Strange Horse of Sandbale by William Black. I have been in Isla more as three times or two times myself, and I have been close to the Lagavulin distillery, and I know that it is the clear water of the spring that will make the Lagavulin whiskey just as fine as new milk. That's actually interesting because the whole water thing doesn't really actually do anything for the whiskey just because of the distillation. It may change it slightly, but not enough to know that when you taste it and you go like, yeah, they should have used a better type of water. No, that's not the case. You can't do that. Maybe if you taste, now the chocolate is starting to appear in the glass. This nice, full, rounded milk chocolate, not that 100% cacao stuff, because I don't like that. It's just too bitter. But just a nice form of chocolate, you know? Yeah, nice. Definitely a 10 for me. This whiskey is perfect. Some people may argue, oh, they should have done this. No natural coloring. All right, I agree. No natural coloring, but it's in a dark bottle anyway, so I don't really care about that. And the color is actually pretty nice. And I think they used coloring just because, well, it has been matured in a lot of bourbon casks. So I think that if they used sherry, they used second or third fill or a lot less sherry cask than bourbon cask. Because bourbon cask whiskey gets lighter than sherry cask. But it's just a nice color. If there is anything added, which there is, then I don't think it's a lot. But I thank you for watching. Have an hour long. Oh my goodness. Yeah, I am trying to make this shorter, but I just wanna... This whiskey deserves a special moment. Ladies and gentlemen, I thank you for watching. I hope you like my new setting. I hope the lighting is alright. I hope, well, my background is alright. Not too busy, not too calm, just nice and pleasant. I hope you liked it. I hope you leave a thumbs up. Maybe even share this with your friends. And I hope that you check in later, because I have a lot more whiskeys coming soon. So I thank you for watching, and I say now. And now I say goodbye.